Hey everybody, we're here at Apex Expo 2019, and one of the really hot topics on the show floor this week has been Bluetooth. Everybody's sort of racing to figure out how to allow passengers to connect their own wireless headphones to the in-flight entertainment system via Bluetooth. I'm here with Harry Gray now from Safran, and they've figured it out, haven't you?
We have, actually. Bluetooth is not anything new. It's something that's been in the consumer market and the consumer industry for quite some time. It's really not even new on the aircraft itself. What we have done, though, is we've made it available so that all passengers on the aircraft can have Bluetooth audio connected to their own wireless headset.
All right. And you've announced some other things this week. First of all, the Rave Ultra system is going to be retrofit on some aircraft from ANA.
We've got a number of airlines that have selected our new Rave Ultra displays and our new Ultra operating system. Essentially, ANA is one of our premier customers, as well as Lufthansa. Well, we've done the same. And they'll be installing the Rave Ultra system, as well as those 4K displays on all the seats in the aircraft.
Okay, now what makes Rave such a standout system?
Well, Rave in itself is unique because it is a seat-centric system. We don't have any large servers or a number of servers that's installed in the aircraft. We've got a single control box that interfaces to the airplane. And then each display has its own content, thus saying it's a seat-centric system. It's like having an iPad at every seat connected by a network.
All right, cool. So we're talking about ANA, Lufthansa. Who are some of the other airlines that are flying with the Rave system?
We've got 65 different customers today that are flying with the Rave system. Most of them are already announced, but we've got a couple of new ones that unfortunately we haven't been able to announce as yet.
All right. Well, you have to let us know when
Absolutely.
We're allowed to talk about that. Okay, before we go to a little demo of the new Bluetooth product, I just thought it would be fun to talk a little bit about the evolution of this company. I mean, I met you for the first time, Harry, I think at Aircraft Interiors Expo maybe 10 years ago, and the system was part of the IMS company.
Correct.
Before, and it's been quite an evolution. So can you just kind of touch on how far you've come?
Sure. Well, IMS was a small entrepreneurial company. I started back in 2007. It was about 50 people, and it was about a $50 million company. We started in the portable media player business. We gained a lot of notoriety in providing portable media entertainment, as well as other software and services type solutions. We then introduced Rave, which was really a compilation of some of the products we'd already developed. And have been quite successful since then, obviously, with the number of airlines that we've come in contact with and doing business with.
That's right. And now you're part of Safran.
Now part of Safran, a very large organization, very, very opportunistic and very important in the industry, doing all the different things that they do, from engines to seats, obviously, from the other Zodiac entities that they've done, a lot of structures as well, but a very well-rounded company. We're very happy to be part of the Safran family.
Great. All right. Now we'll have a look at how easy it is to use the Bluetooth here.
Absolutely. Wonderful. So basically, the screen has a Bluetooth receiver and radio actually built into the dock itself. We are demonstrating it via a Bluetooth speaker right here. The display and the speaker have already been paired, so all I would need to do in this particular case would be to start a audio program, if I can do that with my left finger. And we've actually got the audio playing right now. So no headset jack, no wires, no cables. We're able to do this and offer it for several different passengers at the same time, and we control it by the actual radio strength and be able to offer it to all 300 passengers on the airplane simultaneously.